sleeping.
Well, you check it now. If you check it now, people drink a lot of alcohol, right? They get drunk, right? No, when you get drunk, you don't really meditate. You just drunk and you feel miserable. No, when we smoke, it make you cool, you know, it stimulates your mind and make you sit down and meditate. Instead, you get foolish, you sit down and then you can meditate and be someone. Herb, rum teach you to be a junker, and herb teach you to be someone. Right? I mean, too much of anything, good for nothing, anyhow. Too much of one thing, good for nothing. So, if you have too much herb, it might hurt you, right? But, I mean, earth is a lot in the fullness thereof. And herb is a plant, a tree that grows.
Perhaps the most controversial aspect of Rastafarianism is the use of marijuana as a central part of the philosophy. Officially named ganja, it's colloquially described by the Rastas as herb, and Bob Marley is said to smoke a pound a week. It's outlawed in Jamaica, and a convicted smoker can expect an 18-month jail sentence.
The more you accept herb, the more you accept Rastafari. You dig what I say? We who accept herb, herb is important, but herb is more important to the people who don't accept it yet, because that is a reality. I mean, it's not Sarelen, Sarelen is something that you crave, but you check it in your sense and say, herb is a plant. I mean, herbs are good for everything. Why these people who want to do so much good for everyone, who call themselves governments and this and that, why them say you must not use the herb? You see? And we check that and we can't find, we just see them just say, no, you mustn't use it, you mustn't use it because it make you rebel. Against what? Against men who won't crave, because them crave for the things like Sevelin. Them have some material things and them want to captivate your mind and tell you, say, well, you have to work and put your pension and him keep it all. So herb make you look by yourself, and instead of you want to work for the man, you want to be one of the man too. Not in the sense of how he is, but in the sense of why should you have to bow to these things.
Do you have to smoke to be a Rasta?
No, man. But in this time, I mean, like, for instance, you're reaching a sense where you're strong enough, can take a little smoke. So when all them cars pass, although you live in the city, you don't hear it because you're thinking. Differently if you just live so. Then, you know what I mean, the whole world confuse you and you're worried and you don't have no time to think. And herb is a thing that give you a little time for yourself so you can live, if you use it.
What about alcohol?
Alcohol make you drunk, man. It don't make you meditate, it just make you drunk. When you drink alcohol, you don't meditate. You're more giddy-headed. Herb is more a consciousness.
It must create problems for you, though, when you go different parts of the world where perhaps it's outlawed, as it were.
Well, it's just like what we're saying, is that I don't care. This is the people who make it outlaw. It's but a few. Majority of the people upon the earth want it. And it's just a few, because guns and prisons and bad life treat you bad. So people kinda. But we want some people power. And the only people power is Rastafari.
The sun will shine.
Rastafarianism is very popular in Jamaica, yet in Canada, the United States, it has a bad reputation. People are associated with drugs and the trafficking of marijuana and violence, police arrests.
Yeah, man, them crucified Christ, remember? Christ was a Christian and them crucified Christ, same is not what
no,
it is.
No, but let's go back to the facts. People have been arrested, and the Rastafarians in Toronto, for example, have very bad reputation.
I wouldn't say that the Rastafarians have a bad reputation. I would say people give the Rastafarians bad reputation because the Rastafarians, all of these things happening before the Rastafarians even start coming to Canada anywhere around here.
But the things that are very obvious are things like the way you look, right? To most people who are very conservative in dress, you look quite strange. Plus the fact that you advocate smoking marijuana.
Yeah, you think this, I'll show you this now. Could they tell God that it's not legal?
No, but you're...
They couldn't tell God that it's
not legal. You have a very strong religious belief, but other people don't necessarily share that. And what they see are the obvious things. And isn't it, in fact, true that many Jamaican people get involved in the trafficking of marijuana and therefore get the bad reputation associated with Rastafarians?
People get trafficking. You see, I don't really know anything about those parts of life. You know, all I know about is Rastafari, and try bringing this truth to the people. What do people do with them life? I don't really know about that. I know about my own.
Okay, what is your own? What's your music to you?
The music to me, the music is more than music to me. It go further than music, you know. It go with further than music.
But you used it as a strong message. I mean, words like a hungry man
music
is an angry man.
Yeah, the music used me.
Bob, how important is the ganja to arrest the man?
Ganja is a bird. This is herb.
Does it matter to you that it's still against the law here in Jamaica?
Every law is illegal.
Every law is illegal?
Every government upon the face of this earth today is illegal. Not one of them is legal.